Hey everyone, welcome to your 12th Java game development tutorial series. I am trying to keep this one as short as possible because I have some business to attend to. Anyway, if you remember last time, we were working on our player class and we did some collision detection, and we saw it looks like it works really well, but really it doesn't because it's handling stopping us moving in the left and right and the up and down directions at the same time. Which doesn't make sense, because if we're standing, for example, if we're colliding with the ground because we're standing there, we still want to be able to move left and right. In this system, we won't be able to. So what we're going to do is, right here we've got my rect. I'm going to take that away, and I'm going to put it inside here. First we say my rect equals this. What we're going to do is we're going to get rid of velocity y times delta time right there. So this is only checking our x-axis. If we're colliding, we want to stop moving on the x-axis. See? Next, what we want to do is we want to add our rectangle thing again, except get rid of this, because it's already been defined. My rect equals new rectangle, blah, blah, blah. Now we get rid of the move x times, or plus move x times delta time, and we leave in the velocity y thing. And then we're going to do the intersects thing one more time. And if we intersect now, it's the fault of up and down. So velocity y minus equals velocity y. Now when we run this, it should work. Yep, it works. But we can move left and right. See? Pretty sweet, huh? So, I don't usually use the word sweet, by the way. Not to mean that. So, what we've got here is our very basic code for collision detection and all that. So the next thing that we're going to do is implement jumping for our player. Right here, I'm going to say if, we'll implement jumping, but won't handle detecting the, I kind of want to detect colliding with the ground. Well, no, I'm going to wait until later because I've got to hurry with this. I'm going to say if input dot get key event dot vk up is our jump key, then velocity y equals negative, and now what we want it to be negative. Reason it has to be negative is because, you remember, minus is upwards, plus is downwards. Let's just say 100 for right now. And we jump. I think our gravity could stand to be a little stronger, so I'm gonna go increase the gravity. It kind of gives it, makes it, when you have slow gravity like that, it makes it look like everything's really large. It kind of makes your scale for your game be a little bit weird. But as you can see, we can jump while we're in the air because I didn't handle detecting the ground yet. Which, I don't know, that's pretty cool. But it's pretty neat, huh? Also, you can see we can collide. Oh, also, holding down the key makes you fly right now because we don't have detection for just key taps yet. I'll add that later on, of course. You can see we collide with the bottom, we can collide with this side. We can glide to the top. Everything, our collision detection seemed to work out pretty well. So yeah, that's what we've got right now. I kind of don't want to leave you with so little, but I do have something I have to get to work on. Let's see. What else can I do? Well, there's a cool... Actually, I'm not sure if that'll work. I'm going to do a little experiment here, and you get to see if it works. If it does, that'll be cool. We're going to say negative 2 times 100 times gravity. If this works, this function here basically makes us jump to this number of pixels tall. We can be exact about how high we want to jump. Rather than giving us a jump speed, and then we see what height we reach, we can give us an exact height. And the formula is, sorry, this is not right, math dot square root, I think, the square root of 2 times jump height times gravity, I think, where I make this afloat, I think that's correct. I really don't know. I have no way of measuring what it is. Well, let's see. Does it shrink by half whenever we have the number? It should. But then again, it would anyway, wouldn't it? Let's try setting it to be 1 pixel. See if we jump exactly 1 game pixel up in the air. And we do. I guess there's not really any way to tell, because if we hold it down, we go further. Well, for right now, I'm going to create a little variable. I'm going to call it jump height. And let's say private float jump height equals 50. We want to be able to go 50 pixels in the air. And we might be going 50 pixels in the air. I'm not really sure. But that's a cool little function I found before that basically it lets you be exact about the height that you want your player to be able to jump, and it works not just in two-dimensional games. I found it in a tutorial for three-dimensional game development using the Unity engine. But you know, math dot square root of 2 times the jump height times your gravity value, and it makes it where you will jump at using the speed that is necessary to achieve your desired jump height. Which is pretty cool, I think. You can be really exact about how high you want your player to be able to jump. Alright, I have to get to. Thank you a lot for watching. Those of you who've commented and subscribed, it really means a lot. So if you like this episode, please like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you next time.